Hello everyone, welcome to my weekly Facebook Live. I am Ruth Norton with Ruth's Stamping Corner, and I have a super cute box to share with you today. This is, I'm calling it a double angled lid box. So there are two sides, and you can see the angled part here. And I love how they kind of crisscross there. I think that's really cute and really fun. And so we're going to make this. It's super cute. It's not as complicated as it looks. I know it looks like it's a complicated box, but that's the fun. It's not as complicated as it looks. So we're going to make this in just a minute. And the great thing about this, and you'll see that there's a little Hostess cupcake in there. The great thing about this is that they sell different flavors of those Hostess cupcakes year round. So if you just change the DSP, change the images on the front, you have a box that you can use year round and gift things year round. So it's a great box. We're going to make this one today. Before we do, let's get to everything that's going on. I got my paper pumpkin yesterday. This is September's paper pumpkin. This is the spooky treats. I will be going live in my VIP group later today at 1 p.m. Mountain Time to do the unboxing and to share this. I can't wait. I've already seen the unboxing video. I think this is one of the cutest Halloween kits they've ever done, so I cannot wait to get into this one. So I will be doing that today at 1 p.m. Mountain Time. So if you want to join me in my VIP group, there's a link to join my VIP group in the video description. So there's no requirements to join. It's just a fun little group that where I share a few more things than I do here on my business page. All right, the next month's paper pumpkin, October's paper pumpkin, is going to be Christmas themed. This one's going to be another adorable one. You can see the themed box. I love when the boxes are themed, like the spooky treats one, this one. And November's kit is also going to be Christmas with a themed box as well. So if you don't want to miss out on October or November's Christmas paper pumpkins, you need to subscribe. The only way to guarantee that you're going to get those kits is to subscribe. I know there are people who like to wait and see what they look like and then try to get the refills. The refills are not always available, and especially when there's themed kits or holiday kits, the refills are sometimes not available. So don't count on getting a refill or finding one somewhere else. If you want the paper pumpkin kits, you need to subscribe. Subscribe by October 10th if you want October's paper pumpkin. All right, the Perfect Partners promotion. We're nearly to the end of September. I don't know how that happened, but we are nearly to the end of September. So far, all the dies are still available. So if you haven't ordered the dies that you want for the Perfect Partners promotion, make sure you get that done. They are only available through September 30th or while supplies last. We've used the Playful Piggies dies. There's so many other really good ones, though, so I think that this is a really good promotion to look at. We all love die sets, and all of these dies have so many little extra pieces that they're just really good die sets. Okay, weekly deals. We are nearing the end of our weekly deals, too. The last weekly deals will be posted next week on the 28th, but we have new ones coming. Oh, no, they're not posted. The last weekly deals are going to be posted tomorrow on the 22nd, and then it ends on the 28th. So make sure that you, if you want to shop those weekly deals, tomorrow will be the last weekly deals that they do. So make sure you shop those. All right. One more thing that I wanted to mention. Stampin' Up! Is hosting a World Card Making Day virtual event. This is going to be a really fun one. They are featuring three different bundles. And this one, this warm welcome bundle, which I actually have right here, this one is going to be a brand new one. It is going to be featured in our January through June mini catalog. It's such a cute one. I haven't really had a chance to play with it, but it is so cute, and the dies are really cute. I love those number dies. They are so cute. So if you want to get this, though, you can purchase it now. It's a big sneak peek for everybody, not just demonstrators. You can purchase this now in my online store. When you purchase it, you can also add on a free set of iridescent pearls. You do have to put in that number separately, I believe, but it will come free if you purchase any of these three bundles. But then you can register to join Stampin' Up's World Card Making Day event, and you can be part of the event with and use your new bundle and get all that done. So if you want to get this, I do recommend, if you want to have it in time for the October 1st virtual event, you need to purchase it, I would say, like today, to make sure you get that in, and then make sure you register for that event. And there is a link to register in my September news, and there's more details about that virtual event in my September news. So there's a link to that in the video description too, so make sure you check all that out if you want more information on that virtual event that Stampin' Up! Is doing for World Card Making Day. All right, here's my shopping host code for this month. If you are shopping my online store, make sure you use this host code. All orders receive a PDF with three exclusive projects If your order is over $50 or more, you're going to receive the make and take kit that coordinates with those projects. And if you're this month only, if your order is over $65, you're also going to receive a package of the fine sparkle gems, which I thought I had some here on my desk. These, you're going to get a free package of the fine sparkle gems. This is just to celebrate my birthday month, and I'm going to send those out for free if your order is over $65. All right. Now, if your order is over, let me go back to the shopping. If your order is over $150, don't use that host code because you're going to get the Stampin' Rewards. Okay. Let's talk about what we're using today. So we are making this adorable little box, and I am using two different bundles. I'm using the Hello Harvest bundle, which we're going to talk more about in just a minute. My light is glaring, so we're going to use this bundle. It is such a good bundle. I really love this one. And we're going to use that one that I just talked about, that warm welcome bundle. We are only using the hello from this greeting, but I'm also using this cute little heart die. I love that heart die. And one of these labels, I think it's this label. So we are using both of these bundles. And they coordinate really good together. I love the greetings in that warm welcome bundle. Now let's talk about this one for a second. This one, I didn't know, but it is currently unavailable. When I plan my project, it is currently unavailable. I think that it is expected to be back in stock on the week of October 26th, I think. So later in the month in October. The other thing that we're going to use today is the Rustic Harvest DSP. And so I wanted to pull this out and show you guys. This is the only piece I have left of this sheet, of this pattern, because it's so good. But I wanted to share this with you guys too. Now, this is currently also unavailable. Everybody's planning for their fall projects right now, but it's so gorgeous, this DSP. But this one is supposed to be back in stock the week of October 3rd. So that is just in about 10 days. So you don't have to wait too long for these. And the back sides are all these fun black and white patterns, which are just, they're so much fun. So if you want this DSP, watch for that hitting this online stores again the week of October 3rd. And then the Hello Harvest bundle will be back in stock the end of October. So check back then. If people are just planning their Halloween fall projects right now. But I decided to go ahead and continue with the Hello Harvest bundle, because I think we all have pumpkins in our stash, right? We all have pumpkins. All right, we're gonna start with our box. I'm gonna pull out what I need. So we are going to start with our box base, our bottom here. This is pumpkin pie. So we're gonna make this part first. Okay, and you need a piece that is 6.5 by 6.5. And you're going to score on all four sides at 1 3/4. So 1 3/4, turn, 1 3/4, and just keep going around until you have all four sides scored at 1 3/4. And that's it. That is your box base. I want to make sure that I got them all in the right place. For some reason, I feel like I hit one of them at like 1 5/8 or something. All right, then you need two pieces of DSP that measure 6.5 by 5 3/8, and you're going to need two of these, and you want them to be different, or you can use just opposite sides of them, but you want them to be you want different patterns on your crisscross. Just I think that just shows that crisscross a little bit better. I think you could use the same pattern, I guess it wouldn't matter, but if you wanted two different patterns, make sure you get two different patterns, and you need each of them to be 6.5 by 5 3/8. All right, on the 6.5 inch side, we're going to score at 1 3/4 on each side, 1 3/4. And then on that 5 3/8 inch side, we are going to score at 5/8 and at 2 3/8. Okay. Put this away, and we're going to do some burnishing and trimming. So let's start with this one. So you would do that twice with your DSP. I'm only going to show you once with one. I already have one done. So, but make sure you do that, the same measurements for both of those DSP pieces. All right, for your box base, make sure you use your bone folder. Lots of good burnishing. It helps you out to get nice crisp sides. All right, this box is a square, or the paper is a square, 6.5 by 6.5, so it doesn't matter what side you start on. So just choose a side and cut up the score lines. And then I'm going to fold this piece out of the way, and I'm just going to kind of notch in and take out like a whole triangle piece. And that's going to give us, we're going to be able to tuck these in. They're going to tuck in just like this, and it's going to give us a nice flat edge. And you'll see what I mean when we get there. So on the opposite side, so just turn it completely around from the side you just did. Do the same thing. Trim up those corners. Trim up the straight sides and then cut off the corners. Okay. All right. So your box should look like that. That is your box base. Okay. So we're going to set that aside. For our DSP pieces, this is what we need it to look like. Kind of like little rocket ships. We have that 5H score line here, and then we're going to trim up the sides. So let's do some burnishing. And I did one in advance because this DSP is, it's not easy to see where the score lines are. And so I didn't want to struggle through two pieces. I thought struggling through one piece will be sufficient enough. So I'm going to just burnish those lines. All right, so with that 5/8 inch tab down here, I'm going to flip it over because I think I can see them better on this side. So that 5/8 inch side is facing you. You're going to cut in at an angle on that center tab, just right next to those score lines. Just cut a little angle there. And then cut up that score line. Just cut up it just like that, okay? We're going to do the same on this side. Cut up that score line. Like that. All right, now I'm going to fold this out of the way. I push that off to the side, and we're going to do the same thing. We're going to actually start at the corner where the score line is, and we're just going to trim that off. These are going to be the glue tabs, so they're going to go right inside the box, just like our box. Okay, so that's that one, just like that. And I'm actually going to turn it over to do this one. So we are going to trim the sides. That's going to make our angle. So we're going to go from the score line down here, from this point down to the score line up here at that point. And for this, I'm going to grab my big scissors. You can also use a paper trimmer for this. I'm going to grab my big scissors just so I can do this kind of almost in one full pass. You can get a straight line just like that. All right. And I'm going to flip it over so I can do it on the right side. Do the same thing from that corner score line down to that score line. There we go. All right, that is all of our trimming. So you should have two DSP pieces that look like little, I don't know what you call it, little airplanes, little rockets, whatever you want to call it. All right, so let's put these together. I'm going to use my Stampin' Seal Plus. Use any strong adhesive. You can use tear and tape, Tombow glue, whatever you want. So on these little triangles, not the big triangles, but the little triangles on the DSP, you want to just add your adhesive, and the score line is going to line up with that edge. So just line them up just like that. Okay. All right, we're going to set that aside. This is what it should look like. You have your little tab down here. All right, we're going to do the same thing on this one. And I do have a picture of what the DSP looks like on my blog. So my blog post will go up. As soon as I can get this video up on YouTube, my blog post will go up, and you can see a picture of what the DSP is supposed to look like. All right, so there's our 5/8 tab there. All right, so it's going to look like that. I hope that makes sense. All right, let's put our box together. We're going to do the same thing on these triangle pieces. Stampin' Seal Plus works great for boxes. I do have a love-hate relationship with this adhesive, but so far it's been working out pretty well. Again, this score line with that cut edge, you just go all the way around, and you can just make sure that it lines up nice and flat, that this line lines up nice and flat with the edge of the box. And you have a nice clean edge there. Okay, so do the same thing on this side, just line up those score lines, line up the box edge, just like that. Okay, all right, so that is our box. So we're going to put this together now. So I'm just going to do some adhesive just on this 5/8 inch strip there. Fold over any excess. I'm going to do the same on this side, just on that 5/8 strip. Don't put adhesive anywhere else. And we are going to adhere these to the bottom. So I'm going to flip this over, and I'm actually just going to flip them, tuck them in just like this before I adhere anything down. So my box is upside down, but it's exactly how I want it to go. And then you're just going to fold these over just like that. Those little hair on the bottom. And your box will open just like that. All right, now I do have a piece of pumpkin pie just to cover this up. I think this is 2 7/8 by 2 7/8, I think. Yeah, it's a 2 7/8 inch square. And I just wanted to cover up those tabs. So it's just slightly smaller than our box. Our box is gonna be 3 by 3. So I just wanna cover up all those little tabs on the bottom. This is an optional step. You don't have to do this part, but I just think it looks a little bit better with those tabs covered up on the bottom. And then you have your little box. Super cute, right? All right, we are ready to decorate it. And you can do it either way. So you can fold in the whichever pattern you want first. I'm going to leave the mossy meadow pattern on the outside. That's the one I want to show more of. So, but you could do it either way. All right, so let's do the rest of our box here. So let's bring this back in. Now I've already done all the stamping. So from that Hello Harvest stamp set, I have stamped, let me grab them here. I've stamped two of these leaves and die cut them. I stamped them in Mossy Meadow. And I have my pumpkin that I stamped in Stazon and die cut it. And I stamped it on shimmery white paper. I stamped it with Stazon on shimmery white paper because we're gonna use our watercolor pencils to color it today. We're not using our blends. We're gonna go with our watercolor pencils. And so I'm using 4 pencils and I used both assortments. So the watercolor pencils and then the watercolor pencils assortment 2. So I'm using some from both of those. So I have Pumpkin Pie, Daffodil Delight, Cajun Craze, and Early Espresso. And so we're just gonna color these. So for my stem, I'm gonna use the Early Espresso. And I'm gonna do Daffodil Delight. I'm gonna do them just kind of right in the middle of my pumpkins, all the way around here. Now when you're using the watercolor pencils, you need to use the Stazon ink because you're gonna end up blending these out with either a blender pen or in our case, the water painters, and the water painters will move the ink too much with the Memento ink, and then you'll end up with smeared images. All right, for my pumpkin pie, I'm doing, it kind of looks like candy corn now, but we're gonna do some pumpkin pie here, and I'm gonna go over these lines, the stamp lines with my pumpkin pie, and a little bit more just in the center. I want them to kind of have that yellow shine in the center, but I don't want them to be yellow pumpkins. So I'm gonna add some orange. And then I'm gonna use my Cajun Craze just kind of at the top up here, the top and the bottom, just a little bit like this. And I might go in more with my pumpkin pie. That's the good thing with the watercolor pencils. You can always add as much as you want. And then my Cajun Craze along all of those stamp lines as well. Excuse me. And I'm gonna go in a little bit dark with my pumpkin pie because I can already tell that's not gonna be dark enough. So a little bit darker in these areas with my pumpkin pie. And you can see right now, it looks like a hot mess. That does not look like we want it to look. So grab one of your aqua painters. Our aqua painters come in a set of 3. You get 3 different tips. I think I'm using like the middle tip. And then have a paper towel handy, a little paper towel or napkin. I'm just gonna squeeze some water in it to make sure it's running smoothly, and you're just going to kind of brush over it and paint it, and you'll see those lines, and I'll hold this up just so you can see it. You'll see those the water kind of melt the pencil away, so you can see the just how, like, it's so easy to do and it's so pretty. So you can see the difference. I hope you can see the difference between these 2 panels that I've already done. You can see how it just kind of melts away those pencil lines. Really pretty, and it's really fun. So if you're not sure you can watercolor, or if you're a fan of watercoloring, try our watercolor pencils. Our watercolor pencils are very affordable. It's a really affordable way to kind of dip your toes into watercoloring. You can see just how that one is so pretty. And just keep going. And the colors, you want them to kind of melt together, so it's okay that we're not like cleaning off our brush or we're doing that, and we will clean it off before we go to the early espresso, or if we'd started with that, you'd want to clean that off. But it's just easy to just go over them. It's just like coloring, and you're just kind of mixing in those colors, and that's it. Quick and easy. We didn't use a ton of water, so our paper is not completely saturated. It's not curling or anything, and it's just quick and easy. Just so much fun. All right, one more thing that I just want to mention about our water painters. I know this kind of stumps people a few times when you get them. Your natural instinct is to unscrew it the normal way. Our water painters, you actually unscrew the opposite way. So if you are having trouble unscrewing your water painters, turn them the opposite way. Okay, and that set aside. So let's set this aside. Let's get all of our layer set up. We have a few more things that I've already done in advance. So I have that little label from that warm welcome bundle and I stamped hello on it. And then I have a crushed curry heart that I die cut from that warm welcome bundle. So that is all of our pieces, including a little linen thread bow that I have already tied. So where we are, we just need to assemble these now. So I have a white piece, which I don't remember the measurements. They should be listed on my blog. If not, I will make sure they are listed on my blog. Okay, white piece goes onto a piece occasion craze. And this goes directly onto our box. You can use dimensionals for this if you want. This one goes directly onto our box, just kind of centered into that Mossy Meadow DSP piece. All right, now one of my leaves, I'm gonna put some Stampin' Seal on the back of this. It is gonna go just off the top up here. It's gonna lay flat. Our pumpkin, I wanna put some dimensionals on our pumpkin, so just three. Go. This one will go up there. And I'll put some more adhesive. You can use glue dots or liquid glue, and that one is just gonna go off to the bottom there on the pumpkin. Okay. We're gonna lose our greeting there. For our greeting, I'm going to put that bow right behind it, and I'm gonna grab a dimensional, and I'm just going to just push that, hold that bow in place with the dimensional. Okay. Pull those off. This goes right over the leaves, just like that. Oops, crooked. Let's fix that. There we go. Super cute, right? Okay, and then our heart, I'm going to stick a dimensional on the end of that tag on the front, and our heart will just go right on top of that. And then just to add a little bit of sparkle to our heart, I'm just going to use the Wink of Stella and just cover that with a little bit of sparkle. So that's going to shine. All right, final finishing touch. I have some champagne rhinestones. Use my Take Your Pick tool. And we're going to add just a little smattering of these around. Just like so. And a couple on the bottom. In here. And that completes our super cute little pumpkin cupcake box. Oh, I forgot to show you what was in there. We didn't put anything in there. These are the pumpkin Hostess cupcakes. We're gonna put one of those in. These go fit right in here. And you, like I said, you can find these little Hostess cupcakes year round. And a lot of times they have different seasonal flavors. So it's a really cute box. So really affordable too. You can make a bunch of these. Super fun, super cute. All right, guys, that is it for me today. If you are shopping, make sure to head to my store. Make sure to join me in my VIP group at 1 p.m. We're going to do the unboxing of Paper Pumpkin. It's so cute. I love this kit. So join me at 1 p.m. And otherwise, if you're watching this on Facebook, please share this with your crafty friends. If you're on YouTube, please like and subscribe to my channel. That really helps me out. And I will see you guys later. Have a great day. Bye.